information for both me and for Anna. The prosecution portrayed Anna in a very dishonest fashion. But I think that came out today in Judge Perry's statements. I want to thank my lawyers. I want to thank Steve Sato and Chris Smith. Some people in my situation would not have had this kind of reputation, and the district attorney could have gotten away with what they were trying to do. I also want to thank Judge Perry. He was an honest judge, and he really considered the issues, and he understood this case, and he understood what it was about, and that came out today in what he read.
How difficult has this been for you?
It's been a living hell. I couldn't even put it in words. From the day Anna passed away, really, from the day Danny passed away, these last 4 years, there's no way to put it in words how difficult they've been. I'm grateful to my parents. I wouldn't be here without them. And like I said, my lawyers who got me through this. The first thing, I'm going to go to Washington, D.C. for our Supreme Court case, in Anna's case. And then I'm really going to kind of pick up the pieces, see what's left. I'll have to take some time decide what I want to do. It's possible that I might actually want to do the defense work now that I've seen how the process is operating.
Sir, take a step forward, please, just to the microphone.
You're close to the mic.
A little closer. Thank you, sir.
The jury did a great job in this case. They understood the drug part of it. That's why they acquitted Howard across the board in connection with the drug aspects. The false names was very complicated. Conspiracy law is very complicated. I think they did the best they could, and we have judges that if the juries don't get it 100% right, the judges can fix it, and that's what Judge Perry did.
People don't realize is that she lost her son. And everybody discounts that fact. She's in the Bahamas. She lost her son, who was her main support system for literally half of her life. And then he just suddenly passes away. She was in incredible depression and an incredible pain. And it seems like that whole aspect has just gone out the window, or at least, the people who have tried to portray it, like the district attorney and some of the people who they called, who were, I'm not going to mince words, they were perjuring themselves. Nothing could be further from the truth. Anna was just choosing, she was in pain, she was not a drug addict.
And you have to remember what the judge said. If you weren't in the courtroom, the judge talked about, in California, there's something called the patient's bill of rights when it comes to medication, okay? That means it's the patient's call. The patient is the one that gets to make that in conjunction with or consulting with the doctor. That was Anna's decision. Howard loved her, supported her, and if Anna believed she needed medication, who was it for Howard to say otherwise? That's just not the way it works. I don't care what the analysts say or the celebrity bashers say. Anna made those decisions. She was a smart woman, a strong woman, and she decided what was right for her.
What's your fine?
His fine, he's free. He's not guilty of everything. The charges are dismissed. It's over. Is that clear enough? Anything else?
Thank you very much.